Did you know you can have a game show? Your own game show? Yes, you can, and I'm going to teach you how to do just that. Hang tight. Hi, my name is Nicole Riley, and I'm the creator of Learn to Go Live. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button and turn on the bell so the next time I publish a new video, you get notified. I'm the creator of the Crochet Game Show. Yes, I have a game show myself, and I've run this game show for the last, I think, about a year and a half or so. Super popular, super successful. Engagement is through the roof every single time. So, if you didn't know, I also have a crochet page, Nikki's Homemade Crafts, and I go live on my Facebook page that's called Crochet Patterns and Tutorials, quite often. In fact, I used to have the game show once a month and I had it bi-weekly, bi-monthly, and now I actually have it every week, part of my other show every Wednesday. Super, super popular. Let me show you and tell you a few tricks and tips about it. The first thing you want to do is have a disclaimer. Yes, either write it down, say it in words, whatever, right? Make sure you have a disclaimer. Let's say you do it on Facebook. I'm just going to take Facebook as the example because that's how I do it. Okay, you can do it on YouTube or somewhere else. But I say right away that Facebook is not endorsing, sponsoring, or in any part of this giveaway, which a game show is, right? Because someone wins something, right? So you make sure that you say that no one is, part of this and it's only you. If you have a partner that helps you give those things away, make sure you let them know that XYZ company is providing the giveaway price or whatever you are doing right there. It could be just your own product that you're giving away. I mostly do digital products unless a company is providing a physical one. Then I just, forward the address and the name, email address, or physical address to the company so that they can send out the price. The next thing I do is I have a full blog post about all the rules about the game show. If I don't have an updated version, I definitely say it at the beginning of the game show and give them all the rules. It is super important to really say it out loud. The best thing is if you have it in writing, because there's always people that don't understand, they don't know, and have no clue. So for me, I make it easy. The less rules there are, the better it's going to turn out. Why? Because you don't put so many blocks in there that makes them not want to do it, right? You want to make it easy and like really loosey-goosey and have it fun that they can be part of a game show. Oh my goodness, it's like so cool. All right, so you have it all written out. So for example, for me, my game show, I literally need to tell them, it's like, hey, I'm going to ask you a question at a certain time of their life. And I even display it. I use Ecamm and Stream Deck that allows me to put an overlay right here, and I'll show you in a second how that looks like. And I put an overlay there and said, that is the question. So, and then I say it out loud. Because there is a time difference when you go live, let's say 30, 45 seconds, depending on your internet connection or whatever social media platform you're using, there is a time gap. So when you say the question, they're not going to answer right away, right? You have to give them some time. So I usually go a little bit more into it. I talk about other things that are related to that question so that they have time to type it up and it actually sends it through. Right? Another thing is you need to make sure you tell them that you are the one who sees all the comments in real time. That is a super important thing you want to say, and that should be part of your rules. So what do I mean by that? When a person comments, let's say you're the viewer and you comment on the live stream, you see your comment populate immediately. Well, guess what? No one else does because of the time difference, right? The time lag. You see yours immediately, but they, let's say the other viewers, see it a little bit later, right? And so there could be fighting happening. I've had that before, not like actual fighting, but people were upset about it. It's like, I said it first, I said it first. It's like, well, guess what? The host of the game show sees everything in real time. Because you're the one who, you're like the hub, right, of all the comments. They all come into you. So you get them all in at the same time. So you see who answered first. And I make sure that I say that. I also say that it's not important if they have a typo as long as I can read it, because I understand when you type really, really fast, then sometimes you have a typo and it's okay. As long as I know what you mean, I'm okay with it. So make sure that you tell them, whoever's the first one who answers correctly wins. Yay. And then you get like the engagement up and they all comment. And guess what happens when you, and a lot of comments are flying in? Ooh, reach goes really through the roof. The more comments you get, the more reach you get. It's like crazy. I had one of my game shows go crazy and had like over 100,000 like views and reach, like 100,000 people, 100,000 eyeballs. Yes, it was crazy. That was one of my first game shows I've ever did. And it was so many shares. People loved it and went crazy, literally. So the more comments you have, the better. The next thing I do is when I see the comment fly in, I click on it. What do I mean by that? It looks like this. So here's an example of one that I did actually. I just did my last live show and this person won and this person had the right answer. So I clicked on it and let them see it, right? And then I also do the sound effect. Yes, with that sound effect, it makes the whole thing even better, right? Doesn't it? So I have the sound effect in there and I clap or pretend to clap, right? And I show them, this person won. Oh my God, yay, you won. And then I tell that person to reach out to me. I give them specific instructions on how to reach out to me. Typically, it's through my Facebook page, YouTube page, you know, or YouTube channel. There's ways to contact me, or I give them my email address, right? And say, you know, email me on this email address, give me your email address. Typically you get that when they email you, right? But let's say they message you through Facebook. Well, then you can't see the email address unless they give it to you. Or it's the personal address, you know, their physical address that you're going to need in order to send the price to them, right? So you need to make sure that you have all that in place and you tell them that immediately. You can have as many questions as you like for the game show. I have tried many different versions of it. I found 10 questions to be the perfect number for one game show. If you make it part of another show as like an enticing thing at the end of the show, do 1 to 3 questions. So that way it doesn't seem so long and elongated, right? And then I also have the rule that you can only win once, either one per live show or one per quarter. So it gives everyone else a chance. Make sure you have a running list then, you know, so you know who already won, so that make sure when the next person then comments that you see, oh, the person already won. So this person now won, right? So it's really, really fun to get engagement going. You get them to comment, they win something. It's a win-win situation for everyone. And it's really, really fun. And you can be a host of your own game show. I also make sure that I show them ahead of time, right before or during, depending on if I have to switch something around, right? I show them what kind of thing they can win. So I screen share using Ecamm. I screen share the, let's say, the web page or whatever the company or my own website, depending on what product they can win. I show them, you can win one of these, like the, let them choose maybe, or no, you can have this specific thing. You have a chance to win this. You gotta be ready. Are you guys ready? I literally get them ready by saying, type in the comment section, tell me that you're ready. Are you all ready? Let's get started. Who wants to start? And then they all write, ready, 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 ready. And then you have all that come flying in. And then you say your question. And then you give it like a few minutes, maybe a minute or so. Sometimes it really takes up to a minute. You see the answer pop up. You then talk to the person, say, this person won. You show it off if you can. If you use StreamYard or Ecamm like me, then you can show it off. You have the sound effect. You congratulate them. Yay, you won. And I'm like, so it's really, really exciting. So having all that done, I want to see your version. Let me see your game show version. Let me show you a little sneak peek on how mine looks like. I'm going to let it run for a little couple seconds here. You can see the excitement, right? And the way I talk and the way I move. This is literally my last live that I did, my last live show with the game show. So let me show that how that looks like. So you can see it right here. And I'm going to start playing here because I did it at the end of that show. And you can see how excited I am, right? I have my question right there. This is my crochet game show. And I talk to them about it, right? And I get them talking. Like, as I said, there's a time gap in it. So what I make sure is I keep talking until the comments fly in. I explain a little bit more. Remember, I talked about this. Do you know the answer? I am okay with you having some you know, typo in there. And then I show them a lot. I was like, look, look, the person did it. And then I show off and then I'm really like excited about it. I also have the sound effect going, which you can't hear right now because I turned it off, but I'm like so excited for them. And I talk about what to do next. So that is literally how I do it. This is how I do it for every single question. And I'm really excited for them. I celebrate them, show them off, and tell them what to do right after. So this is how you can do your own game show. Show me yours. I want to know if you're going to do your own game show on a live stream. Ooh, how exciting is that, right? So leave a comment below. Let me know which one are you going to do? Which niche are you in? I want to know what kind of game show you are going to create. Don't forget to like this video. Share this video with your friends. If you have some entrepreneur friends, small business owner friends, they might be wanting to run a game show too. Let them know about it. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Turn on the bell to get a notification next time I'm live or publish a new video. I hope this video was helpful and I hope to see you next time. Until then, bye!